Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. You're probably wondering exactly what just happened, and more importantly, how did this just happen? The Master Sword has returned to the forest? What? Did I just lose the Master Sword? Well, no, not exactly. All credit goes to a YouTuber by the name of Versat13, who recently published a video where they performed this previously undiscovered glitch, and I'm going to show you step by step exactly how to perform it for yourself. When performed correctly, the glitch will allow for one of two possible outcomes. One, you can duplicate items like weapons or shields. And more interestingly, two, you can trigger an unused hidden animation where the Master Sword flies off into the sky, having the game notify you that the Master Sword has returned to the forest, from where it came. With the help of English translators, Sage Han, and Game Freak Dude, along with a few hours of perfecting the glitch so that I can explain it to you, I've been able to construct my own step-by-step tutorial to share with the community on how exactly to pull off this glitch in the easiest possible way. A shortened version of this can be found in the description, but if you're having difficulties, continue forward and I'll break it all down for you in detail. First though, it's important to understand why this glitch is even possible. So, what is happening here? This glitch is made possible by taking advantage of memory limitations within the game. As more objects are trying to load into system memory, the game will begin to lag, causing newly spawned objects to temporarily overwrite the memory held for objects in your inventory. We take advantage of this, and with properly timed actions, you can either duplicate your items or trigger the Master Sword animation. So, here are the glitch requirements. Here's everything that you'll need. You'll need a location in the game with 9 or 10 enemies in one zone. Versat13 uses a camp in the southwest of the Gerudo Desert. It's located just north of the shrine and fairy fountain. You should be able to use any similar location though, but for the sake of consistency, I'm duplicating the glitch as Versat13 has demonstrated it. This camp contains 10 bokoblins, 4 blue ones on the watchtowers, and 6 black ones inside the Skull Rock. You'll also need a bow for each enemy, but not just any bow will do. You'll have to use 10 bows that are capable of shooting 3-5 arrows at a time. I'm using the Savage Lionel Bow with a 5 arrow shot ability. I also suggest having a weapon capable of stunning enemies with electricity. As you'll see in this tutorial, I'm using a Thunderblade and Shock Arrows. And of course, while dealing with the Bokoblins, it also helps to have a Bokoblin mask on. Now that you have the location and all the items that you need to perform the glitch, here are the glitch steps. 1. Steal all enemy items and drop your multi-shot bow for them to pick up. Start with the archers. How you do this is going to depend entirely upon the location you've chosen to perform the glitch. Here in the desert at this camp, I found it easiest to first disarm the tower guards one at a time, making sure to be quick enough as not to have any of them blow their horns, alerting the rest of the bokoblins in the skull cave. I steal their single shot bows and then run back to the top of the skull, where I then drop off that bow. Rinse and repeat until all 4 of the archers have been disarmed. With all the archers now disarmed, and having none of them blow their horns to bring attention to the whole group, it is now time to deal with the Skull Cave Bokoblins. I recommend simply gliding into the cave with your Bokoblin mask on. With a group of 6 having surrounded you, they'll try to figure out who or what exactly you are. Now's the time. Charge up your Thunderblade so that you can do a single spin attack and then release the charge button. This will shock them and they'll drop their weapons. Run around as quickly as you can now and pick up all their weapons before they have the chance to pick them back up. The whole camp should be alerted to you now. The archers will jump off their posts and join in on the ruckus. Drop your 10 multi-shot bows so enemies can pick them up and start shooting at you. Do what works for you, but make sure that all bokoblins are now carrying bows and run for your life. Arrows are going to be flying everywhere, but this is exactly what we want, so try to stay alive. Run beyond the entrance of the cave. For the most part, the archers will all stand together and shoot at you from a distance, which should give you the opportunity to avoid the arrows as best you can. The archers may move over time as you attempt the glitch. Just keep a good distance and try to avoid the arrows. This is where the memory glitch occurs. Wait until there are a lot of arrows flying and hit start to enter your inventory screen. You'll know that the memory glitch is optimal when Link starts to lose clothing, his hair, weapons, or even entire parts of his body. This is what you want to see when you enter the screen. If it looks glitched out like this, then you've reached the optimal environment to perform the glitch. Now equip the Master Sword, and then exit out of the inventory back into the gameplay. With the Master Sword now equipped, next time there's another volley of arrows, pause the game to enter your inventory again. If you have the Master Sword equipped, and Link is missing equipment objects or parts of his body, now's the best time to equip a different weapon. It doesn't matter what you choose, but I suggest you select one of the Bokoblin weapons that you recently just picked up instead of using a weapon that you'd like to keep. Another indicator to tell you that this glitch will probably work is that you won't hear the regular sound effect that plays when you equip a weapon. Unpause the game and return to the gameplay with a new weapon, but don't use that weapon. Next time there are a lot of arrows again, hit start to return back to the inventory. If you see Link holding the Master Sword now instead of the new weapon that you just equipped, while at the same time your inventory screen is telling you that this new weapon is actually equipped instead of the Master Sword, then you're almost there. Drop that equipped weapon. Now prepare yourself. This is the moment that you've worked for. The moment you unpause and leave your inventory screen, the Master Sword will fly back up into the sky and return to the forest. So make sure that you're prepared to maneuver your camera to look up to the sky, because the animation happens very quickly. And there it goes. That's all there is to it. Now that you know how to do it, practice. If you're having difficulty, trust me, it gets much easier with practice. So, why would I create this tutorial when I could have just shown you footage of me doing the glitch myself? Well, it comes down to a message that Forsaw13 left for the glitch community at the end of his video. According to Sage Haynes' translation, he says that Forsaw13 asks that people recognize the potential for this glitch, and to use it for more than just item duplication. He wants people to find new discoveries using this glitch, and to improve on it. The prospect of other possibilities for glitching within Zelda Breath of the Wild are very exciting, so give it a shot for yourself in different places all over the Zelda map, and let us know in the comments section what you've been able to discover on your own. I hope that this tutorial has helped you out, and if it has, be sure to give it a thumbs up and share it with a friend on your socials. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.